Hi, this is Stan Pons with Florida Bible College. I'm excited to let you know about a very special concert and training that we're going to have on the Labor Day weekend Saturday. We've got Megan Garrett of Casting Crowns that'll be with us at 2 o'clock in the afternoon at Florida Bible College, and we'd like you to be a part of that if you want. We also have our Gospelized seminar called Building a Gospel Advancing Ministry. Give us a call and we'll give you more information about this very special free concert and training. 407-412-9322. Or visit us online at floridabiblecollege.com.
Welcome, everyone. We're so glad to have you with us. For those of you that are our guests here this morning, my name is Stan Pons, and I'm the president of Florida Bible College. And you happen to be at a wonderful, one of our best, what we call Florida Bible College alumni reunion. One of the things that we wanted to do is to bring in some very special music for worship and a time for us to worship the Lord together as a family. And you guests, I want you to know that you are so special to us, that you're part of our family. Once you come in here, we're all together in God's family and have an opportunity to worship. Now, I want you to know, not only do we have a special guest here to sing for us, but we also have a very special person that we've asked if she would do the honor of introducing Megan and Ryan. Now, this is not just anyone who knows Megan and Ryan. This is one who knows Megan and Ryan. But also, for some of you, when we were at school, we had a wonderful time with Bubba Ryan and, of course, Cindy as well. And we have wonderful memories. Most of you, if not all of you, know that Bubba's in heaven right now, celebrating with the Lord, and he's worshiping the Lord as well. And what a blessed time that is. But I wanted to have Cindy Bryan come down and have the honor of introducing for the very first time in a public setting like this, her daughter and wonderful son-in-law, Ryan. So, Cindy, would you come?
After my dad on the hike. Okay. This has been so good so far to be here with so many friends and so many memories. And like Stan said, you know, Bubba passed away 6 years ago, and he wanted so badly for his baby to come and sing for his friends from Florida Bible College. So I get to introduce my son-in-law, which every mother-in-law wants to do that. You know, Ryan, I don't tell him enough how much I love him. And,
no, you don't.
And so...
Say one more time. Are we recording in the back?
on to Megan. Ryan is a youth worker. He's a youth pastor and heads of the youth at Church of the Apostles in Atlanta. And the thing I'd like to say about Ryan is he's one of the most amazing youth pastors I've ever seen. And his love for the Lord could not be stronger. And that makes this mom so very happy that he's father of my grandkids. And my daughter Megan, she is one of the loves of my life. You know, I've traveled with her with the band for 11 years. I've watched the sacrifice that she's made, bringing her children along with her, homeschooling them, leaving Ryan. They do their ministries separately, then they come back together and they minister together. And their love for the Lord together is just an amazing thing. Bubba's looking down and smiling right now. Amen. So, these are my kids, Beck and Ryan. Why don't y'all stand? We're just going to worship together. Thank you.
I will bring a sacrifice. I will bring a So I lay me down. I lay me down, I'm not my own. I belong to you alone. Lay me down, lay me down. Oh, and on my heart this much is true. There's no life apart from you. Lay me down.
Says, it will be my joy to say your will, your way. So you guys sound so good this morning. Let's sing this out. It will be my joy to say. And it will be my joy to say your will, your way. Your will, your way. It will be my joy to say your will, your way. Your will, your way. It will be my joy to say. Your will, your way, always, always. Y'all sing out so good. Let's sing it one more time. Let's sing it out with all we have. It will be my joy to say, your will, your way. It will be my joy to say, your will, your way. It will be my joy to say. Haircut. I might have the hipster shoes on, but I really am a redneck deep down. And, I like to ride four-wheelers and shoot guns. And amen. And but one part about being a redneck is
is James in the Bible a lot. He's a redneck. I don't know if you knew that. And because James shares over 30 nature references in the book of James. I don't know if you knew that. And then rednecks like the outdoors, and then rednecks just tell it like it is. And that's what I like about rednecks. So, and then you put people who are rednecks and Jesus, they just tell Jesus like it is. Amen? Amen. And so this morning, we'll talk about this in just a second, but one of my passions, or my main passion, is Jesus. And Jesus saved me, and when God called me his son, that changed my world forever. And so I know a lot of y'all have sat down and took a little break, but we're going to have to have one more song, I promise, and I'm going to give you a chance to sit down. All right, can we stand up? Because you can't sit down when you sing, I'll Fly Away, amen? I mean, come on.
Come back for me when the sky is over.
I saw the light, no more darkness, no more. are, again, so glad to be here. My name is Ryan, and y'all know that already, my wife Megan. Just a little bit about us, if there's anything that we can share about us. We have three main passions in our life. And we like to do a whole lot of stuff. We have a whole lot of fun. But we have three main passions for us. If it was to define us, who we are, these three things are it. Number one, we are passionate about Jesus. We love Jesus with everything that we have. He has changed our lives. He has made us new. He has brought us from darkness to light. And we were lost, but now we're found. We were blind, but now we can see. And He has made all the difference in our worlds. And we are blessed and honored to be able to serve Him. And we are just we are thankful. Number two, we are very passionate about our family. We've been married now for 13 years. We just celebrated our 13th anniversary. It's been so much fun. I tell you, everybody tells me that I outhunted my coverage, and I get it. I understand, because I have married a beautiful, beautiful woman who loves Jesus, and we have three kids: Lily, Lucy, and Eli. And Lily's 10, Lucy's 5, and Eli's 3. And Lily's our beautiful little sensitive 10-year-old. She's just great. Lucy is our firecracker. She's all over the place, and she was just, her name means light, and that's exactly what she is. She's just great. And Eli, he is a 3-year-old boy. He's awesome, but he can be a knucklehead sometimes. We love him. And our third passion, seriously, is just to make disciples. That's what we feel like God has called us to do. When Jesus said, the two greatest commandments are love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And the second is to love your neighbor as yourself. We take those serious, but He didn't stop there. He left one more before he left this earth. He says, go and make disciples. And that word go, I'm sure you already know this, but that word go isn't just go. It's literally means in the Greek, as you are going, as you are living your life, make disciples. And that's what we're about. I've had the honor of being a youth pastor for about 16 years now. And that's what we want to do every time we get the opportunity to love on teenagers. And what part of my role in being a youth pastor is I get to support Megan and what she does with Casting Crowns. Our normal is normal to us. It's not normal to other people, but our normal is just normal. And the reason I say that is Crowns usually travels Wednesday through Saturday, and they're usually gone. And then they leave after church on Wednesday night. They come back for church on Sunday mornings. And that allows me to be able to serve and do student stuff on the weekends. And don't have to worry about coming home and tucking the kids in bed and students over the house being rowdy because there's nobody to wake up. It's just me and the dog and the cat. We have a cat. But pray for me. And, but God has just blessed us. And when Megan and I met, I was leaving worship and a student pastor. And she was obviously leading worship, and Crowns kind of kicked off. But there was one song that we both have worshiped to, and we just loved. And so we want to share with y'all our very first song that we played together. Is that cool? Is that all right?
Yeah.
And this song means a lot to us, and we hope that it means a lot to you. First, I need to tune this guitar because it is driving me crazy. Megan, would you say something on this?
I can sing, but I'm pretty awkward when I talk, so just give me a little bit of grace here. But this song is one of my favorites. It's called Pure and Holy Passion. And when we met, we both knew that we were called to ministry. Not necessarily. I think God works. He calls us in seasons. I don't think He says this is an absolute for your life, but He calls you and says, I just want you to do the very next thing that I ask you to do. And that might be talking to somebody you know, on the street, or ministering to your children, or loving someone that's hard to love. It's not always standing on a stage in front of thousands of people doing these big things. And I think we have this mindset that you have to be special or be important to be able to really be doing ministry. And that's not what God says at all. God says just to do the next thing that I ask you to do. And it's all important, and it's all for the kingdom. And so whether we're standing on a stage or whether we're sitting in a chair next to my children or a student, we always just want to have a pure and a holy passion for what God has called us to do. And we want to run after Him, and we want to follow Him in everything that He does. And that's what the song is about.
Thank you. Anchor holds again and again.
we pause right in the middle of this song. Right where we're at, God, it's just you and us. And Father, I just ask that in the stillness and this moment, there's so many things going on in our world. I'm not meaning the world as a whole, God. We know there's a ton going on in the world. But in our own individual world, there's so much hurting, there's so much pain. There's struggles going on, Lord. God, we're not here for... God, I really pray, and we are so honored that this has been considered a concert with Megan and Ryan. God, we don't want any recognition, Father. God, we are here for you, Jesus, and you alone. So maybe there's someone in this room who, Lord... God, you have been their cornerstone. You have walked with them in so many different areas, God. But right now, there's a need to just be reminded that you are their cornerstone. So, Father, I would pray right now that you would encourage my friends here. Because, Father, you want us to lean into you. You want us to fall into your arms, Lord. So, Father, right now, if there's something on our hearts that we need to just give to you, God, allow us to do that. Because, God, one day you're going to come back, and we're going to meet you, and there will be no more tears. There will be no more pain. There will be no more heartbreak, no more cancer, no more bills. Amen. Because God, you have a plan for us. We can't wait for that day. So Lord, I pray that right now as we sing this, Lord, these would be more than just words. From a song, they will be the cry of our hearts, Lord, that you are our cornerstone. Because you're so worthy. When he shall come, and the trumpet sound, oh may I Christ the Lord.
tells us about Christ being the cornerstone, everything that our faith and our life is built on top of, the main support that holds who we are and what we do together. I was fortunate enough to be raised in a family that taught that strategically and intentionally put Christ at the cornerstone of not only their lives, my parents' lives, but of the cornerstone of our family as well. And not at all that our family was perfect by any means, but I had amazing parents who poured Jesus into me from the moment I took my first breath, and eternally grateful for that. I know some of you know my dad, some of you don't. Probably all of you have heard Bubba Bryant at some point this weekend, and that was his name, Bubba Bryant. Didn't know his name was actually Charles Maximilian Bryant until I was much older. Some of you probably didn't know that either, so there's a little bit of trivia for the day. When my dad got really sick, he went from being perfectly healthy, goofball, never anything, having anything wrong whatsoever, to a pretty quick decline. And it was amazing to watch my mom walk through that with such faith and with such hope, because she knew that she's not the one that holds their lives, that God is, and that our days are numbered, and God's good. No matter what goes on in this life, God is so good. And it was amazing, still amazing, to watch her walk through that. But when my dad, when we got the call that my dad, we should probably come, he probably was going to be seeing Jesus very soon. At that point, he was in a hospital bed right in front of my mom's fireplace, my mom and dad's living room, with a sign that Isaiah 45:11. Chip. I told you I'm awkward. Jeremiah 29:11. Right? Yes, correct. Okay. I'm awkward, I'm telling you. I'm sorry. Oh no, you're good. I'll move on. But just seeing God's promises resting over my dad in that moment, and our family got to gather around him, and at the time I was 6 months pregnant, and so that made it difficult, because I knew it was going to be the first grandbaby after that that was not going to have the pleasure of knowing my father. And so I struggled through that a little bit, but I have no doubt, I know they met. And Ryan told you a little bit about our kids, but our first baby, Lily, was dark hair, dark skin, dark eyes. I mean, just olive complexion, everything. A lot like him. Lucy is our second. I was 6 months pregnant with her, and I prayed one thing, and it was a very selfish prayer, but I prayed, God, and I know brown eyes are dominant genes and all that, especially when dad has them, but I prayed, God, if you would just be so kind to give my daughter my dad's crystal blue eyes, that I can look in every single day and remember him. That would be, like, amazing. So, and I prayed that for the rest of the time that I carried her. And when she was born, she had the most beautiful crystal blue eyes that were almond shaped, just like my dad. And I wish I would have brought a picture of that. I've got this, like, side-by-side picture that's almost a little freaky how similar they are to making the same face, too. She definitely got his light of the spirit and goofball personality, but every time I look at my daughter and I think about that season in my life where, you know, God truly gives and God takes away, but blessed be the name of the Lord. I can look into her eyes and see that God cares about the little things too. He hears us in the little things, and that's just been a big lesson to me that God's taught me through that. I had the opportunity, the privilege, to sing a song at my dad's funeral. Being 6 months pregnant, I didn't make it through it. I had the skin of my teeth, I think, but I've gotten to sing this song in front of thousands of people over and over, but none will match getting to stand on a stage in front of all the people that loved him most and celebrate his life, because one thing that my dad loved to talk about, the side jokes and everything, was Jesus and God's grace and his mercy that he has for us. And I can still picture my dad sitting, he was very proud dad, he would be, whenever I saw him out of the audience, and this was one of his favorites to hear me sing, and I got to sing it over his life, and I want to share it with you guys now. Oh, mercy.
You're good, good Father.
So I have to stop and I have to talk. Worship leading is really difficult at times. And because you're singing and you're worshiping, obviously, the Lord, and you're singing words off a screen or off a sheet, and you're playing guitar, playing piano, and you're trying to just give everything that you have, but then that little thing in your head starts spinning, your brain. Because you're trying to keep ahead of the songs, and you're kind of trying to keep ahead of the next verse and the next, how to play the song, the next keys and next chords. And as I'm singing the song, I have to be honest with you, my brain's not here. Because there's... when I sing this song, I think about God being a good, good Father. I told you, my second passion is my children. Probably one of my favorite things in the whole world is that when my children crawl up in my lap and call me Daddy. In fact, I tell my kids, this makes me a bad parent, but whatever. But I tell my kids when they tell me they love me, I tell my kids, I don't want you just to say I love you. I want you to say I love you, Daddy. Because I want them to know that when they crawl up in their daddy's lap, it's all going to be okay. Whatever they're going through, whatever problems, whatever struggles, whatever joys, whatever fears, all they have to do is crawl in their daddy's lap and let me hold them. So when I think about the song, struggle through it. Because I think that's exactly what God wants for us. He wants us to crawl up in His lap and just recognize Him as a good, good Father. He wants to wrap His arms around us right where we are. You know, I think about that verse out of Titus that we just sang. It's His mercy that saved us. He loved us enough to hold back what we deserve. He gave us His Son Jesus so that we might have a relationship with Him. He is a good, good Father. That's one of those insert an amen portion right there. He is a good, good Father.
Amen.
So as we sing this chorus, can we just sing it like we're singing it to our Heavenly Father who's right there with us? Right here in this room and right here in our midst, and just call out to Him and tell Him what He is. You're a good, good Father, God.
You're a good, good Father. So You are. So You are. So You are. And I'm loved by You. So I am. I am, so I am Your good, good Father. So You are, so You are, so You are.
So I am, so I am, so I am. You
Jesus came.
You know, you were at a concert that wasn't a normal concert. They didn't have all their backup band, and they certainly showed us they, as good as they are, they don't need that backup band. And this waffle wasn't another concert. You know, we kind of, I know this sounds crazy, but we kind of really kind of touched Bubba the whole time, those of you who are new here. But I know that some of you went way beyond Bubba. It may cause you to think about some of our other brothers and sisters in Christ from FBC that went on ahead, maybe even brought it into your own life. You begin to think, I've lost someone in my family. And as you were thinking about that, those words really impacted you. Today, this was really thrown out all over Central Florida for people to come. And it's highly likely that we may have some guests that are here. And we want you to know that you didn't crash our party. This party was for you. And we're so glad that you came. But I think if I came to something like this, I would be thinking, wow, they sure sang a lot about the Lord. And I kind of knew they would be doing that. And boy, I was really touched by that. And they're talking about someone who's already passed and is heaven. And you might be thinking, man, what do I do with all of this stuff? I think, again, if I came into something like this and I wanted to know about the Lord and singing and all of that, and then if you're thinking about death, I'd be wondering, I think I sealed the deal, but maybe I need to do a checkup from the neck up. And you know, that last song that was sung is probably everything you need to know about what you need to do to know that you have eternal life. You know, living, he loved us, and he sure did, and he dying, you know, he's talking about the Lord, and he died on the cross. And when he died, he made the complete payment for all of our sin and for you. He died for me. And then they sang a song about mercy, the song that was sung at Bubba's memorial service. That's a unique term, mercy. There's a verse in the Bible that goes like this, that the law, which is necessary, came by Moses, but it was grace and truth that came by Jesus Christ. Then if you do that little study through scripture of grace and truth, you're going to find that sometimes the Lord had the writer take that word out and put another word in there, put the word mercy in there. But always it was grace or mercy before truth. And so the truth of the matter is that God loves you. The mercy of it is he will take away all of your sin and prevent you from having what we all would deserve. And then he couples that to grace, and he says, I don't just forgive you. I give you a whole lot more, way beyond that, eternal life. And the neat thing is that he doesn't swap out truth. It's the same truth, Old Testament through New Testament. And the truth of the matter is, living, the Lord really, really loved us. And he's alive today, so he loves us today. But he didn't die because he had to pay for sin. But he just didn't die. He also came back again. That resurrection that took that power for him to go from death into life is the same resurrection that gives us new life in Christ too. So those of you that are guests here today, I want you to know that God really loves you. And he proved that to you when Jesus died. And he did all the work, all that ugly stuff on the cross. He paid for it all so that he could offer to you that free gift of eternal life. And he proved it when he came back to life again. But that's not all. He just didn't come back to life again. He's coming back again, and those trumpets are going to sound, and that we're going to have eternal life because he continually loves us. So that's the truth of all of that, but now what are you going to do with it? And here's the only thing he wants you to do is to realize that it's true. Realize that's the only way to have eternal life. But now you need to place your faith in Christ. Now it's not a big thing to do that, but it's an important thing. You need to do it truly and completely. And I pray that today, if you're a guest, that you would place your faith alone in Christ. We didn't talk about becoming a student at Florida Bible College or a particular church or denomination or whether or not you could even say. What we are saying is, can you admit that you're a sinner? We all can. We've all missed the mark. Therefore, we need mercy. And he also gives us grace, and we'll take that grace because that also gives us eternal life in heaven. So would you right now, wherever you are, just in your own mind, just have that little conversation with the Lord tonight. I think you can do that because most of our whole songs were all sung about praising, singing unto the Lord. We were talking to the Lord through all of that. Now have one of the most important conversations you could ever have so you can make sure that you have sealed the deal, that you trust in Christ. Would you bow your heads and close your eyes for just a moment? A
God does love you, and he sent his son for you on the cross. He went to the cross and took all the things that we've ever done wrong and will do wrong and satisfied that payment before the Lord. And God the Father smiled on all that. And now he offers to you the free gift of eternal life to us. The most expensive gift he could ever give to you, his own life. Now I pray that you'll just simply, in your own mind, transfer your faith from whatever it might have been in yourself, some system that you kind of thought was the way to make it to the next life. Or maybe even you had no faith in anything. But take whatever that faith is, but place it completely in Jesus Christ. And simply say to him, Lord, I thank you that living you love me, dying you saved me, rising you have claimed me and declared me just as if I've never sinned. Lord, I thank you for that. I'm counting upon you, a God who cannot lie, for the eternal life that you've promised. And now I know I have it. Now, it's not important whether or not you raise your hand for me to know it, for me to pray for you. I'd love to do that. So maybe you just like to talk to someone, or maybe have someone pray with you. My sweet wife and I are here. I'd be glad to do that. So come up and see us. If you've got a question, talk to us. I want to just make sure that as many people who hear this have done just that, seal the deal. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we come before you, broken in need of you. We're desperate for you because when we're truly honest, we know that we cannot do anything ourselves at all to truly ever please you enough so that you then would save us. So, Father, we come to you just as we are, a sinner. But, Lord, taking you at your word when you say, believe me when I tell you that if you trust in me, you have eternal life. And so, Lord, right now, we do believe that you are the Lord who died, that you're God of the flesh. And since you did all of that, now we're going to count on that. We're going to count on you, and we're going to say thank you for doing that for us. And may we now live the rest of our life, a life that would be pleasing to you, and what we like to say, a thank you life for what you've done for us. In your name we pray. Amen. Now, dear ones, you're probably wondering what's going to happen next. Well, obviously, it's lunchtime. How many of you are hungry? I know I am. And those of you that know where you like to go, there's places around the area that you can meet. Those of you that are part of the reunion, you're more than welcome to partake of what you've already ordered in the fellowship hall. But this afternoon, we're going to have the privilege of hearing from Megan and Ryan again at 1:30. Coupled with them, though, we're adding to it, Greg Steer of Dare to Share Ministry. It's a national youth ministry equipping youth leaders and adults and pastors on how to speak into the next generation leaders here and globally. And his message is not a fundraiser. His message is really to equip us to really understand the youth of today, where they are, and then how we can help them come to know Christ and to become champions for the Lord and what that means. And that's a seminar this afternoon talking about advancing a gospel-type ministry. It's all free. It's the gift of the Alumni Association and the college to the communities here in Orlando to pick up on some extra knowledge in their ministry. That'll be at 1:30 with Megan Ryan and also Greg. It'll go to about 3:30, and then we have our wonderful banquet for the FBC people. And so I want you to know that you're welcome. If you have any questions, the welcome table out there is like a concierge desk at a hotel. They'll be glad to answer your question. Are you glad you're here today? Yeah. God bless you.
Florida Bible College, equipping students for a life of lasting commitment to Jesus Christ. Open up your eyes, time to see the light. Florida Bible College.